Right, it's very misty. I've just emerged, creeping through a field back there with what looks like very recent cow pack, but not like in the last couple of days, 3 or 4 days ago. But that looks more recent when it's fleshy like that, look. That could still be the sheep, because I've just come in this field and saw shapes. Now, they do sometimes mix cows with sheep. There's a herd there. I'll just zoom in. There they are. They're moving away from me. But it doesn't mean there aren't cows in here. Sometimes they even put a bull in with sheep. That can fool people, you see. I'll just have a bit of a scan. But I can't go across the middle of the field like I normally do. Just in case, I've got to stay by the wall. Yeah, just in case, I've got to stay by the wall. Now, this is an easier wall to get over because it's got a bit of fencing you can put your feet in. Now, but that other, back there was nowhere. You'd have to literally scramble. But here, and what saved me 4 years ago, say 4 years, I've got it all recorded somewhere, was a big pole like this. Because it was further up, I was able to grab that big pole and then climb up the runs of that fence and stand on that wall when the cows came charging up here towards me. And every now and again there's a big pole like that. Now there's the sheep. I don't know if you can see them. They're lurking in the mist. And you can't always see these animals. And these are white. They stick out a bit with the green grass, you know. With the cows, their size should really stick out. So there's cow pack. Not sure about that one. When they've got like riddled with holes, you know they're more than a day old. That doesn't mean that the cows aren't still in here. Now these sheep are following me now. That one there is coming up. You pretending to be cows, are you? Eh? You're saying, what are you doing in our field? I don't want the sheep giving the cows a warning. Now there's another stile coming up in a minute. This is another big field to get across. I've also got quite a few stiles to climb over after this big field, which I'm only, when I get to the stile, I'll probably only about halfway across it. And I've come from a long way. This is an experience. I think if I'd been here last week, this would have been different. The cows would have still been here, definitely. They would definitely still been here. And they have been out. There's some hay there, scattered. They could still be in this field somewhere. Now, further along, there would be patches. There's no barbed wire. A bit further up here where I was chased. See, the sheep have disappeared now, look. They've disappeared, but you can tell cows were out here. Scatterings of hay. And that's, which is normally put out for cows. Of course, I've got no idea if there would be cows in that field, see? It's all fairly dodgy, isn't it? Right, I'm going to turn off for a bit now. It's going to get very misty as I get higher up here. Heading for the remote cottage on the hill. Not yet, not for a while. Still a lot of walking to do in the mist. A lot of walking. Over and out. Right then, into the mist we go. Crossed over a stile there, got over that long field. The problem with this field, which also has cows in it, by the way, is that this one, the path can disappear very quickly in this mist. I'm just going to head straight. And the other thing is, with this one, there's no wall. So if a cow's suddenly started coming now, for example, this is all silage by the look of it, I wouldn't have anywhere to go. And it's very difficult, even in the daylight, with blue sky and everything, you can't always see where the stile is at the other end of this very long field. The path has already disappeared from view. So all I know what I'm going to do, is it could be over there, or it could be still where I'm walking. It's very difficult to know. I've got a feeling it could be here. I'm just going to go straight. It is quite creepy, actually, doing this. And it reminds me, just for a minute ago, the werewolf in London, where they go up to Yorkshire. And they say to them, don't go off the track. Now, all I've got to do, I mean, I think I've already wavered, the track could be over there. I'm just going to keep, from what I remember, just keep going straight. Although straight can't always be found when there's like, that looks like two paths. So, yeah, you can't see no reference points. But if you keep trying to think what is straight until you get to a wall, then you'll know you'll be able to find a stile. But like I say, even on a clear day, you cannot see that stile. It blends in with the wall. It's very clever how they've done it. And it could be further over, but I'm going to try and keep on these tracks here. Now, like I said, it reminded me of the werewolf in London, where Michael and Jack are walking. They'd left the pub. It wasn't very hospitable. They left the pub and they just said, whatever you do, don't leave the track. What do? They're on the road. And then suddenly, they leave the track. Creating my own horror films. Anyway, all I'm going to do, what I do is keep walking straight, because if you start diverting, you could end up going around in circles. Do you know what I mean? Obviously, if I set the compass, if I had my compass with me and set it just to keep going straight, that would have been alright. It's just that this is quite a big exposed area. It looks like they've been putting silage out here as opposed to cows. I haven't ever walked through here with cows in it. I know there's another field over there, but that I made a mistake once going into another field. See, even now I've made a slight change of direction. Don't know if anyone noticed. I made a slight change of direction there. I think I should be over here. Wait a minute, let me just see if I can pick it up again. I think I should be heading more, because that's going to that gate. And I know you don't go in there. I know that. That won't take you to the stile. You have to stay in here. And I think I might be able to make something out with a naked eye now. Not sure. Or was the stile in there? Sometimes I get very lost. And I might think, oh, it's in there. You know? So, and it could be in there. I can't actually see it now. I am lost, by the way. What we'll do... Right, wait a minute. What we'll do, there's that over there. We just walked down here a bit, because I'm sure it was in this field. We just go to where I can see two space poles. If not, we're going to go over that gate. It could be that it was in the other field, but I just can't remember. All I know... No, it's not here. It maybe it was in that other other place then. Yeah, it's so easy it is to get lost. I've got to go back here. I don't want to divert too far. I can't see, my reference point is usually a copse and the remote cottage. But at least we hit the wall. Maybe it was, maybe the stile was in the other field. I'm not quite sure at the moment. Or it's up in that corner there. I'll have a look in a minute. Very difficult to see. Let's go round a minute. So I said, this is a good example of how you get lost. Because if I was here now, I wouldn't have a clue where the bloody other stile was. I wouldn't have a clue. I'm walking for all squelchy stuff. I might have to go through that gate in a minute. But what I'm going to do is walk up here a bit. Yeah, it's very confusing, that. Very confusing. I still feel I'm... Maybe it was further down. Yeah, that was very confusing there. I don't really think it's this way, by the way. I'm just going to look round there, but I am lost. I am lost. But I know I've got to go that way. One way or another, I've got to go that way. But I don't think this is it. Wasn't this complicated? But I did get muddled up with this once before, with this stile. I did get muddled up with it before. I don't think it's in here. It's very confusing. This is where you lose valuable time, you see. It's because I haven't done it. Well, I have done it, but normally I rely on my sight. I don't know where I am at the moment. I don't know. I haven't got a clue, actually. I'm quite lost. It can't be that far off here. Surely, Sheila. Just go up there. There's another gate. We'll get through this gate here. It doesn't look as muddy. Yeah, this is a good example how you get lost in the mist, everyone. Yeah. I don't know where that stile went. Now, I had this before. A couple years back, I lost the stile in broad daylight. It's what's called a blender. Right. Can't be far away unless they've moved the stile. Imagine if you see cows now, what would I do? I don't know where I am. All I know is that I'm going to walk straight across this field, right? And hopefully I'll see the copse. It's a big, big copse full of trees. Let's just hope there's no cows in here, look. Because I don't know where I am at the moment. I feel very lost indeed. But it's a good experience. Right, everyone, because the camera needs to get out of the mist, I will come back to you when I know where I am. And at the moment, I don't at all. I'm totally lost, everyone. Okay? Not totally lost, but I am lost. This is not the path I normally do. It's going across this field, one way or another. And I'm taking a risk. Hopefully all the cows are out. I don't recognise this, where I am with these ridges. Right, over and out, everyone. I'll come back on when I'm not coming back on until I know where I am. Okay, bye.